Everyone, if commercial real estate defaults are expected to get worse, why is the largest commercial real estate broker the best performer in the S&P 500 today? For that side of the story, let's head on over to our own Zara Burton. So, Zara, what's going on here?
Well, Carol, in a nutshell, you're talking about a capital raise. The company came out and said it wants to raise $550 million worth of capital. Very curious, because LaSalle, also another REIT, or that is a REIT, it is also raising capital, and yet that stock's selling off today. But CB Richard Ellis, that is on the rise because of this capital raise. And one of the things that's interesting, I've been talking to a number of different analysts, and what they're saying is that because John Paulson, billionaire hedge fund John Paulson, he is investing, in other words, biting into this company, he sees potential upside. This stock has had a really good run year to date. It's up more than 100%. And by John Paulson going into this stock, it really tells investors that it has more to run. Plus, Carol, another issue as well is that it has some debt. It had made a $2 billion acquisition a couple months ago, and this acquisition was financed all in debt. And so what they're saying is that the fact that they're able to raise money pays down some of that debt and puts them in a better position.
But talk to me, Zara, a little bit about the outlook for this company. I mean, commercial real estate still remains very weak. We know that.
Yeah, and even though the stock is doing very well year-to-date, as I just mentioned, it's still off 56% in the past 12 months. Financial institutions, they've been cutting lending for real estate purchases. Employers have been giving up office space in the recession, reducing the commissions that CB Richard Ellis gets. And also, they did forecast for the second quarter that their earnings are only going to be, well, they're going to be 50% lower than last year, and earnings are going to come in at a maximum of 7 cents versus 16 cents a year ago, trailing the average analyst estimate of about 9 cents. Also, rating agency Moody's came out, affirmed the company's credit rating, however, did say that the outlook remains negative for this company.
All right, so what are you hearing? I mean, the stock is up so much this year. Talk to me about why that is.
Well, it has to do with some rearrangements of their credit arrangements with some of the banks. Remember, I just talked about the fact that they had a lot of different debt, so it just had to do with some credit arrangements.
Got it. Zara, thank you.